to Beijing, but a day like this will make all the winter months of training a lot easier, won't they?
Of course. I mean, it's a big, big enjoyment. And I think, I must say again, it looks how a really good team works. Okay, we lost something yesterday, and then some people jumped in. You might not predict they jump in, and I think that's great. That's a great team atmosphere. I think that really should give us a big motivation for next year for Beijing.
Great. Well, thanks very much for talking to us, and have a very quiet night tonight in Munich. I'm sure the rowers will be out on the Tyne celebrating a really successful 48 hours overall. That's our lot from here. We're saying goodbye from Germany, and we're going 800 kilometres north to Germany, to Hamburg, in fact, and we're going to say guten Tag to Craig Doyle.
Thanks, John. Hello and welcome to Hamburg for the 2007 BG Triathlon World Championships, where the best in the business have gathered to fight for this prestigious title. There's also over 5,000 age group athletes here representing their countries. I'm one of them, although I'm looking at a paramedic finish more than a podium finish at the moment. More of that later on. Let's get things going with a tour of the city. Hamburg is often referred to as Schmuddelwetter, which literally means foul weather. I can't think why. Not that it stops this lot. With a lake in the middle of the city, they either run round it, cycle around it, or swim through it. This is a sporting city, which is interesting considering the locals are called hamburgers. Now, the Reeperbahn is known for its less sporting physical activities, but this is the most celebrated corner in the area, the Kaiser Keller, where the Beatles really kick-started their career back in the early 60s. Can't buy me love. Hamburg is now the second largest ocean harbour in Europe and processes nearly 9 million containers every year. It's also the leading raw coffee hub in the world, which is interesting because I've had 3 cappuccinos since I came here and they've all been rubbish. The ultimate piece of Hamburg trivia is that it has more bridges than both Venice and Amsterdam put together. Now, isn't that something to be enormously proud of? Yeah. And outside this stunning building, the town hall is where the World Championships will be decided. This is the Rathaus at the end of the Rat Run, if you like. Now, the reason Hamburg is such a great location for a World Championship is that all the racing takes place in the centre of the city, so there could be 250,000 people out watching the race when it kicks off. Now, in they go into the water in the Inner Alster here, up around the buoys. Then they come through this bridge, a very low bridge, about 120 metres, quite creepy when you look up through it. And they jump out here, T1 at the Rathaus Market, right in front of the town hall. They jump on the bikes, and they've got 8 laps of a 5K course, bringing them up around here, right through the centre of town. And then T2 again in front of the Rathaus. Off they go on a run, up alongside the lake, 4 laps of that, and they finish right there, bang, in the centre of town. Well, it seems quite fitting that things should get underway here on the Alster, at the very centre of life in Hamburg. And this is the swim section where they'll battle it out for that key position going into the first transition. Although it's not all about being in the lead pack going into the bike, as Michelle Dillon proved a couple of weeks ago in London. Yes, she had a very good bike, but with a great run, she won the gold medal and that $15,000. So I caught up with her earlier to see how confident she feels going into these World Championships. So, Michelle, here we are, Hamburg, but are you still clinging on to the memories of London?
Yeah, it was a good win. I'm really happy with London, and obviously I was on a bit of a high there for a while, but come back down to the ground now and ready to focus on this one on the weekend.
Tough old field here this weekend. Where do you think you stand going into the race?
You know, I think I'm in good shape and I've got a really good chance of, you know, doing really well. I think it just all depends on, you know, how I feel on the day and having a bit of luck and it all coming together, really, because I'm going to be obviously a little bit behind in the swim, but my swimming's improved, I feel, and I'm just hoping that I have a good enough swim on the weekend to sort of get me in a good position and not be too far back, and then be able to work with sort of the packs to get up, and if I can come off in the lead pack on the weekend, I'll be really happy.